close this. So now we have putting whitefish in for the leeks.
So everybody, this is the leek. Basically every animal that will want to annoy you to death, like your chair. We are in the clouds. We literally cloud. Can you see how like high we are? We're that close to the engine. I mean not the engine, the clouds. I mean we are close. I can literally see the clouds over there. You can see the clouds over there too. It looks like mist. I mean, clouds are made up of water vapor. Oh, this is the landslide. Yeah, landslides, avalanches.
Okay, I've not been several times. I just want to know your kilometers. So.
it's about 9:22. We are still in Montana. I mean, Montana is a big state, so. I mean, yeah. So it's hard to imagine what Edmund Hillary had to go through going up Mount Everest. Yeah, I mean, you're close to the clouds. It's about, well, let's see the time, 9:36. So we have some time left till lunch. I believe at around lunch, we should be getting to a big city. YouTube video is going great. Filming the YouTube video in the middle of a train.
We're walking down
in India. Science and confidence in the light. Nice. now going downhill. We have passed the Continental Divide. So going downhill, exiting the Rocky Mountains. So I've heard that all water and rivers on this side of the Continental Divide goes to the Gulf of Mexico, and on the other side, everything goes to the Pacific Ocean. So that's interesting. I actually did not know that. So this is the Ruby of the Amtrak. So the bathrooms, if you're in a sleeper, in the bathrooms are normally in the middle of the coach, close to the stairs. On the coach car, down the stairs would be a bunch of bathrooms. On the sleepers, there are bathrooms with showers equipped in them. So if you need to take like a shower or anything, you can go there. I might show you the showers later on if I have time. The engine, the P42, about 16 cylinders, goes to about 120 miles per hour top speed. Well, of course we're not going at 120 miles per hour now, because downhill. 120 miles per hour top speed. It's also used by Amtrak for long journeys. Because say if you put the P42 on the Amtrak Alaska's journey from Boston to Washington D.C., that would use up lots of gas, diesel. So what they use is a high-speed engine, not like the Japanese ones, slower than the Japanese ones, but high-speed. So I believe after Shelby there's just a prairie. So this is Browning. Interesting. Well, Browning is a big city. So we are past the Rocky Mountains. They're at the plains now. So the rest of the journey is basically just gonna be plains. Nothing much. So the nice part is over. So now it's just gonna be a bit boring. I mean, unless we spot Bigfoot. Thank you. look like it's made out of wood. Train. Welcome to Shelby, Montana, kids. So, everybody, we're back at the prairies, and we're also back in the observation car. So, if you didn't know, these are the Great Plains. They were a white oil part in America's railroad. So, yeah, I mean, it's just nice out here, and in the distance, back there, you can see, hills. They look like mountains, but they are not mountains. In fact, they are hills. Chicken masala, a bondi, and some coke. If you come to Amtrak, I'll give you a choice of a brownie or a blondie. I highly suggest the blondie. If you like the blondie is a brownie, just it's white. And it's a toffee crunch. We're still in the Great Plains. still in Montana. Casino. Wow. Hi guys, we're still in Montana. Wow. open air since the morning. Leaving the station. Wolf Point, Montana. Oh, bien sûr. Everybody, there's a river over there. The Missouri River. It goes to Missouri, so it's called the Missouri River. So enjoy. Guys, we just got into North Dakota, which I'm happy about because we were in Montana for like a few hours, so yeah. We're still seeing lots of planes. We did see some oil, like oil pumps and stuff like. So, everybody, we're now approaching the city of Williston. This is going to be one of our stops. It is not an open air stop. But yeah, we're getting to the city of Williston in North Dakota. And what I've noticed about North Dakota is there's lots of oil plants. like scattered here and there. Yeah, so I guess this place has some oil in here. That would be oil tanks. So, what's surprising about Wilston is that, I mean, it's not a very well-known city, and we can still see, like, Menards, Ford, there's a Walmart here. So that's just surprising that it's, not, like, that big, and they have these big companies here. Oh, that's a cute dog coming out of that car. Here's another example. There's a Buffalo Wild Wings there. In all of the other small towns we passed through, we did not see a Buffalo Wild Wings. I mean, again, it's not exactly a small town, it's one of, how do I say it, one of the bigger small towns. So we're picking up speed again, and I do not know where the station is. Is he stopping at the station? Another bump. Here are some grain mills. So, guys, it's surprising to hear this, but Amtrak doesn't have any own lines. Oh, and by the way, this is the station. But as I was saying, Amtrak. Amtrak doesn't have much of its own, like, railway lines, so normally it goes by. Oh wow, that's a beautiful steam engine. That's truly beautiful. Northern Pacific. That's beautiful. But Yeah, that's a beautiful engine. Okay, so guys, it's now dinner time. I got what I had for dinner day before yesterday. Shrimp in lobster sauce with salad, a blondie, and apple juice. So yeah, we got some butter. We're in the North Dakota Plains. I mean, this is a nice place to have a romantic dinner. So, if you're coming with your girlfriend, this is the best time to eat. It's about 8:31 Central Time. So, yeah, I guess I'll tuck in. Okay guys, we're in Minnesota now.
And I apologize, we're out of orange.
Guys, we just passed Anoka, for us. St. Paul Union Station will be our stop. It's around 6:23 local time. We're just having breakfast. And I'll check in with you when breakfast comes. Thanks. So guys, we got our breakfast. I have a muffin, omelets, and some orange juice. Oh, and starved meal, Tabasco. So once I get to downtown, I'll start filming again, and see you in a few minutes. So guys, now we have a good view of St. Paul downtown. We're coming into the Union Station. On the other side of us, we have a great looking river. Guys, we're now at the Union Station. That's a good view of St. Paul there. Amtrak is normally an hour late. This Amtrak is an hour early, so that's something to be happy about. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And if we get 1 million subscribers, I'll have my family and my friends throw a bunch of water balloons at me. Let's just say that. I don't know why I'm saying this, but I promise you that. So thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. See ya.